Radio, Westwood One presents the Dr. Demento Show, brought to you by Drixoral Sinus, the only sinus medicine that takes sinus pain away and keeps it away for up to 12 full hours. Rare records and outrageous tapes from yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Mad music and crazy comedy from out of the archives and off the wall. Some of the funniest songs ever sung, and now and then some of the worst. Baseball season starts next week, and we'll salute opening day with Who's on First, the dying Cub fans' last request, and more. And for our Alaskan listeners, we'll have some moose music. And a little later on, we'll commemorate the breakup of the Soviet Union with a few of the many demented songs that have been sung over the years about communism. And of course, we'll have the Funny Five countdown. I'd like to start, though, with a capitalist slave labor song inspired by the old chain gang songs from the southern prisons. It's kind of a white collar holler. Stan Rogers.
Well, I rise up every morning at 7:45. Some woman who's my wife tells me not to be late. Wow. I kiss the kids goodbye, I can't remember their names. Wow. And week after week, it's always the same. And it's homeboys, can't you code it? Whoop, and program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling up the data on the Xerox line. And it's code in the day to give the keyboard a punch. Wow. Then browse, correlate, and a break for some lunch. Wow. Correlate, tabulate, process, and screen. Wow. Program, print out, regress to the mean. And it's homeboys, can't you code it? Program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling up the data on the Xerox line. Yeah, then it's home again, eat again, watch some TV, make love to my woman at 10:53. I dream the same dream when I'm sleeping at night. I'm soaring over hills like an eagle in flight. And it's home, boys, can't you code it? Program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling up the data on the Xerox line. Someday I'm gonna give up all the buttons and things. I'll punch that time clock till it can't ring. Burn up my necktie and set myself free. Cause no one's gonna fold, bend, or mutilate me. And it's homeboys, can't you code it? Program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling up the data on the Xerox line. And it's homeboys, can't you code it? And program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling up the data on the Xerox line.
Stan Rogers with White Collar Holler, written by Nigel Russell. While we're on the subject of technology run amok, taking over human beings, check out this one from the Duh.
My baby had that surgery, and now she's perfect as can be. Traffic stops when she walks by, old men wheeze and cough and die. NASA wants her out in space, but they don't want her for her face. MIT and Harvard too want her for her big IQ. Silicone, silicone brain implants, banish all your ignorance. Be profound with confidence with silicone brain implants. Before the surgeon stuffed her head, I said, I like you small instead. If it leaks, as I've been told, what happens when your skull explodes? Silicone, silicone brain implants, think thoughts of significance, make sense of our presidents with silicone brain implants. Look out now, here comes the doctor, keep your body out of sight. You call it cosmetic, say you won't regret it, will you bet your life you're right? Woke up this just say I'm doing fine. The FDA just banned her mind. Guess I'll miss those bulging eyes, but most of all her new hat size. Silicone, silicone brain implants, lots of wisdom you'll dispense. Keep the dance in great suspense with silicone, silly silicone. Silicone, silicone brain implants, expose your intelligence. Get a genius in your pants with silicone brain implants.
I'm just sitting in a vacant lot with a bird sitting on my head. I'm just sitting in a vacant lot with a bird sitting on my head. Wicked, wicked, cruel, cruel world, what have you done to me? I belong in someone's arms,
and I belong in a tree.
Wicked, wicked, cruel, cruel world, this is no kind of life. I should have a house and bed,
and I should have me a wife.
We're just sitting in a vacant lot, and we haven't got a dime. The bird and me, lonely as can be, we're together all the time. Wicked, wicked, cruel, cruel world, what have you done to me? I belong in someone's arms,
and I belong in a tree.
Wicked, wicked, cruel, cruel world, what I say is no lie. We've been sitting here so long
that I forgot how to fly.
I'm just sitting in a vacant lot,
and I'm sitting on his head.
The things we want, we haven't got. Need a tree and house and bed.
Wicked, wicked, cruel, cruel world, what have you done to me? He belongs in someone's arms,
and he belongs in a tree.
Wicked, wicked, cruel, cruel world, this is no kind of life. He should have a house and bed,
and he should have him a wife.
Wicked, wicked, cruel, cruel world, what have you done to me?
I belong in someone's arms.
Couple of real cerebral songs for you there. David Seville with A Bird on My Head, hit tune from 1958. And the contemporary dementia of the D-U-H, silicone brain implants. That came in the mail not long ago from North Hollywood, California. Coming up, one of the bands that did the most to make the 1970s bearable, plus some moose music on the Dr. Demento Show.
The pressure's like an inflated balloon.
It's like something's filling my face up.
My sinus pain goes from my eye sockets to my jaw.
What makes my pain so bad is that it lasts so long.
Try Drick's Oral Sinus, the only sinus medicine that takes sinus pain away right away and keeps it away for up to 12 full hours. And for 12 hours, Drick's Oral Sinus relieves the pressure and congestion that causes the pain.
Whoever developed Drick's Oral Sinus really knows what sinus pain is.
Drick's Oral Sinus. Use only as directed.
What do you think of new Cineburst gum?
I've never seen nothing that color before.
Words can't describe it, my man.
Those flavor crystals frighten me.
Wow! Whoosh! But wait, did I say outstanding?
Cineburst crunches. That could be a violation in this state. I'll get back to you.
Yes!
New Cineburst with flavor crystals. May not be suitable for adults.
Dr. Demento Hotline!
Hi, this is Lori from Sacramento, and I listen to the Dr. Demento Show on KSEG. I'd like to hear a great tube song called Don't Touch Me There.
Ooh, baby. Move closer to me. I've had all that I can stand. Take hold of me with your hands.
Oh, baby, you give me the chills. whisper low in my ear. Let me know how it feels just to know you are near.
Your body gives me a thrill as it leans against mine. I love how it feels with your jeans against mine.
My darling, I want you so.
I love your sweet, sweet lips.
I love your salty taste.
I love your fingertips.
When I reach for your waist,
touch me there. The Tubes on the Dr. Demento Show, a song written by a couple of great little-known talents from the San Francisco Bay Area, Ron Nagel and the late Lila Jane Dornacker. The Demento Hotline rings again!
Hi, this is Sue from Fairbanks, Alaska, K101. We just got goosed by a moose, and we thought maybe you'd like to tell the rest of the world about those moose goosers. Thanks!
Them moose goosers! How about them moose goosers? Ain't they the clues? Up in them boondocks, goosing them moose. Goosing them huge moose, goosing them tiny. Goosing them meta moose in they hiney. Look at them moose goosers, ain't they dumb? Some use an umbrella, some use a thumb. Them obtuse moose goosers sneaking through the woods. Poking them snoozy moose in they goods. How to be a moose gooser? It'll turn you puce. Get your gooser loose and rouse a drowsy moose.
Ago last Monday, I was driving home at night. The guy in front was pokey, he wanted to see the sights. I didn't want to be Gumby, so I switched to passing gear. When I pulled up alongside him, he offered me a beer.
Hey man, you want a beer?
No thanks, man.
You sure?
No, I'm Bob.
Okay man, we'll see you later.
Pulled into my driveway, walked up to my front door. I went inside and noticed there were hoof marks on the floor. I measured them with utmost care and thought the tracks were deer. Then suddenly it hit me, what was happening in here?
There's a moose in my house.
I thought it was a deer.
There's a moose in my house.
But now it's really clear.
There's a moose in my house.
Got a major problem here.
Moose, moose in my house.
What am I gonna tell my dog?
Checked my mail and found a box from the Sierra Club. I ran into the bathroom and found moose hair in my tub. My bill from Bell had phone calls to the Yukon and Montana. My toothbrush smells like moose breath. I'm missing my pajamas.
There's a moose in my house.
I don't know what to do.
There's a moose in my house.
I stepped in moosey poo.
There's a moose in my house.
My dog is turning blue.
Moose, moose in my house.
Hamper. I looked in the backyard and found a troop of Cub Scout campers. I asked them why that they were there. It is my yard, you know. They said, we are moose hunters. This is the place to go.
We're moose hunters.
Oh, yeah?
They're in your house.
I know. You want to get out of my yard? I know this all sounds stupid. You probably think I'm dumb. You might think I'm a mental case or maybe just a bum. But someday you just might come home and find a big surprise. A moose takes up a lot of space and really draws a fly.
There's a moose in my house.
I thought it was a deer.
There's a moose in my house.
But now it's really clear.
There's a moose in my house.
I should have had that beer.
There's a moose in my house.
Got a major problem here.
There's a moose in my house.
I don't know what to do.
There's a moose in my house.
I stepped in moosey poo.
There's a moose in my house.
I hope that there aren't two.
There's a moose in my house.
My dog is turning blue.
There's a moose in my house.
Scott Lanningham with Moose in My House. Somebody give that man a record deal. He's got lots of great songs that he sent me. And Mason Williams, multi-talented writer and musician with one of the couple dozen Them poems he wrote and recorded in the 1960s, Them Moose Goosers. The moose, the largest member of the deer family, a moose weighs nearly a ton and is not to be trifled with, but there is something about this species that quite a number of people have found comical. Perhaps the most demented thing ever written involving a moose is this delightful old folk tale told to us by Utah Phillips.
Went down and got a job with the rural electrification in the Navajo Indian Reservation. Running electric power lines into all the Navajo outhouses. Was one of the first people to wire ahead for a reservation. Finally, I'll tell you about the worst job I ever had in my life. Worst job I ever had in my life was working for the Santa Fe? Yeah, it was the Santa Fe Railroad, south of Las Vegas, Nevada. Yeah, that's the old Mormon Muddy Mission, you see. It's way out in what the Navajos call the boonies. Out in the desert. Now, the job was Gandhi dancing. Now, Gandhi dancing used to be in the old days. Gandhi dancing was when the Irish were building the railroad. Of course, the first transcontinental railroad was built by Irish laborers. And they used these long-handled shovels called Irish banjos that were made by the Gandhi Shovel Company of Chicago. Now, the Irish laborer would take the wide end of the shovel when he could find it, and he would jam it in under a rail or a tie, and he would climb out on the long handle, do a little jig step out there, and that would lever the tie up or the rail up, and you push gravel in underneath it and tamp it down, and that levels the roadbed. See, that's what Gandhi dancing is. Leveling the roadbed so the damn train doesn't fall off as it goes by, which is just a big drag for everybody. Now, they don't do Gandhi dancing the normal way anymore, see, like they did in the old days. Nowadays, they run three cars out on the line. They run a box car out there that's a bunk car. You sleep in it. Got bunks in there 18 inches apart. And then you got a tool car with your tamping irons and your tongs and your double jack hammers and spikes and all of that equipment, see, to do the job. And then you got a cook car. I mean, there's no restaurants anyplace around, so you got a cook car. Pots and pans and a coal or wood-burning stove and a long table down the middle to eat at. Only thing they don't hire is a cook. That's because they're cheap. Saves them money. The rule is that in that crew, they're supposed to pick among their own members who's going to be the cook. Now, they don't try to do it sensibly, like draw lots or decide who the best cook is. What they do is they wait and find out who bitches and whines and pisses and moans the most about the cooking. And they say, all right, wise guy, you think you can do better, you get to be the cook. Well, that was me, see? Old alligator mouth. The new man on the crew, and that was the worst food I'd ever had. I mean, it was dog bottom pie and pheasant sweat. Otter water comes out of an otter. It's a terrible, terrible stuff. Some people might think it's a delicacy, but I thought it was garp. So I complained, and they said, all right, wise guy, you get to be the cook. That made me mad, because I didn't want to cook. But I knew if anybody complained about my cooking, that they were going to have to cook. Armed with that knowledge, I sallied forth over the muddy river. I was walking around among the cheatgrass and bunch grass there, and I looked down, and there was just a hell of a big moose turd. Biggest damn moose turd, that was a real steamer, damn. I looked down at that meadow wafer, and I said to myself, self, I'm gonna bake up a big moose turd pie. Because if anybody complains about my cooking, they're going to have to cook. So I tipped that pasture pastry up on edge, and I started rolling it down toward the old cook car. Boom, boom. I got it down there and leaned it up against the side, and I climbed up in the cook car, and I baked up a hell of a big pie shell. And I baked that moose turd in it as slick as you please. And I crimped the edges with my thumbs and laid strips of dough across it and garnished it with a sprig of parsley, a little paprika. It was beautiful. Poetry on a plate. And I served it for dessert, waiting for the first hint of a complaint. Well, this giant dude come in, about 5'40". I mean, he was big. Throwed himself down like a fool on the stool. Picked up his fork. Took a big bite of that moose turd pie. Well, he threw down his fork, and he let out a beller, and he yelled, my God, that's moose turd pie. It's good, though.
And so is that story. Utah Phillips, fine storyteller, singer specializing in railroad lore. Well, I'm told that piece is a little questionable biologically, but we'll let that pass. Moose turd pie, Utah Phillips on the Dr. Demento Show. As you can see, we specialize in the unusual, old and new. Call me up and request the weirdest song you can think of. I just might play it. The request line's one of several fun things you can do with a touchtone phone and the Demento hotline. You can also hear Demented Entertainment anytime you want, 24 hours a day, starting Monday, April 6th, the hotline will feature the White Collar Holler, plus highlights from next week's radio show. The Demento Hotline, 1-900-773-7333, 75 cents a minute, 125 first minute, 1-900-773-7333. If you're under 18, ask your folks, 1-900-773-7333. Or you can write to us, get information about the Demento Society, which has tapes and CDs for sale, also a membership kit with a demented glossy photo press kit, and our information-filled newsletter. The address, P.O. Box 884, Culver City, California 90232. Once again, P.O. Box 884, Culver City, California 90232. We play ball next on the Westwood One Radio Network.
Who wants Trident?
I do.
Love the taste?
I do.
Cinnamon, fresh mint, four more flavors.
I do.
Sugar-free Trident, the one gum more dentists recommend, actually tastes great too. So who wants Trident?
I do.
Who does?
I do.
We do.
Who?
I do.
I do.
Good for your teeth, great taste too. Who wants Trident?
I do.
It's like being hit right below your eyes.
If someone put a needle in your head, it would explode.
My sinus pain just lasts so long.
I can't even wear my glasses because of the sensitivity.
Try Drixoral Sinus, the only sinus medicine that takes sinus pain away right away and keeps it away for up to 12 full hours. And for 12 hours, Drixoral Sinus relieves the pressure and congestion that causes the pain.
The people who make Drixoral Sinus really understand sinus pain.
Drixoral Sinus. Use only as directed.
What do you think of new Cineburst gum?
I don't like anything new. Get that microphone out of my face.
Cineburst? Oh, absolutely. It's the best.
it crunches. Those kids deny it, but I know the gum crunches.
It's too much for my dad. Sometimes it's almost too much for me.
All I can tell you at this time is that we're keeping a very close eye on it.
Yes!
New Cineburst with flavor crystals. May not be suitable for adults.
Demento.
Johnny certainly loved baseball. He knew the names of all the famous ball players and what their batting averages were. He could tell you all sorts of things about baseball, such as who was in the Hall of Fame, what teams played in the World Series, and who had the best pitching records. Johnny liked baseball better than almost anything in the world, but poor Johnny. When he tried to play baseball himself, well, he could just never hit the ball. And all the kids would shout,
"Here comes Johnny up to the plate. He bites like a fish on a pitcher's bait. He swings too soon, he swings too late. He goes down swinging like a rusty gate. Little Johnny strike out, he can't see the ball. Little Johnny strike out, he won't ever get a hit at all."
What do you want, Costello?
No, Abbott. I understand that you're going to be the manager of the Lou Costello Junior Youth Foundation baseball team.
Yes, we just organized the thing.
Oh, you did?
Sure.
Well, I'd like to play on the team myself. You know, I know something about baseball.
Well, that would be accomplished.
Well, I'd like to know some of the guys' names on the team, so when I meet them on the street or in the ballpark, I'll be able to say hello to them.
Why, surely I'll introduce you to the boys. But you know, strange as it may seem, they give these ballplayers nowadays very peculiar names.
You mean funny names?
Nicknames, pet names, like Dizzy Dean.
Brother Daffy?
Daffy Dean. And
I'm their French cousin.
French cousin?
Goofy.
Goofy. Well, now, let's see. We have on the bags, we have who's on first, what's on second, I don't know who's on third.
That's what I want to find out.
What silly name? I say who's on first, what's on second, I don't know who's on third.
Are you the manager?
Yes.
You know the fellow's name?
Well, I should.
Well, then who's on first?
Yes.
I mean the fellow's name.
That's it.
That's who?
Yes.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
Who?
The guy on first.
Who?
The first baseman.
Who?
Have you got a first baseman?
Who is on first?
I'm asking you who's on first.
That's the man's name.
That's whose name?
Yes.
Now tell me who's on first.
That's right.
I want to know what's the guy's name on first
no,
base.
No, what's on second
I'm
base?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who is on first?
I don't know.
He's on third. Now, we're not mentioning third. Now, let's get together.
How did I get on third base?
You have to mention his name.
If I mention a third baseman's name, who did I say is playing third
no,
base?
No, who is playing first?
I'm not asking you who's on first.
Who is on first?
I'm asking you, what's the guy's name on third?
What is on second?
Who's on second?
Who's on first?
I don't know.
He's on third.
There I go, back on third again.
But I can't change their name.
You got a first baseman?
Absolutely.
When you pay him off every month, who gets the money?
Every dollar of it. Why not? The man's entitled to it.
Who is?
Yes.
So who gets it?
Sure he does. Sometimes his wife comes down and collects it.
Whose wife?
Yes.
Well, all I'm trying to find out is what's the guy's name on first base?
Listen, what is on second base?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who is on first?
I don't know.
Third base.
I pick it up. You got an outfield?
Well, surely.
The left fielder's name.
Why?
I just thought I'd ask.
Well, I just thought I'd say.
Then tell me who's playing left field.
Who is playing first?
Stay out of the infield.
Now, don't mention their names out here.
I want to know what's the left fielder's
what
name.
What is on second?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know. Third base. Look, the left fielder's name.
Why?
Because.
Oh, he's center field. As well as I do.
Look, you got a pitcher on the team?
Wouldn't this be a fine team without a pitcher?
The pitcher's name?
Tamara.
You don't want to tell me today?
I'm telling you, ma'am.
Then go ahead.
Tamara.
What time?
What time what?
What time tomorrow are you going to tell me who's pitching?
Now, listen. Who is not?
I'll break your arm, you say, who's on first. I want to know what's the pitcher's
what's
name.
What's on second?
I don't know. Third base. You got a catcher?
Charlie.
The catcher's name?
Today.
Today, and tomorrow's pitching.
Now you've got it.
Now I've got it. I don't even... Look, all we got is a couple of days on a team.
I can't help that.
A couple of days.
Don't get excited, now.
Who's your next side?
Take it easy.
You know, I'm a pretty good catcher myself.
Well, tell me.
Now, I'll catch today myself.
All
I'm
right.
Catch.
Yes.
And tomorrow's pitching on a team.
Yes.
Now, tomorrow throws the ball, and the guy up bunts the ball.
Yes.
Now, when he bunts the ball, me being a good catcher, I want to throw the guy out of first base, so I pick up the ball and throw it to who?
Now, that's the first thing you've said right.
I don't even know what I'm talking about.
Well, that's all you have to do.
Is to throw the ball to first base.
Yes.
Now, who's got it?
Naturally.
If I throw the ball to first base, somebody's got to get it.
Yes.
Now, who's got it?
Naturally.
Naturally?
Naturally.
Oh, so I throw the ball to naturally.
You do nothing of the kind. You throw the ball to who?
Naturally.
That's it.
That's what I said.
No, you didn't. No, you didn't.
Did I throw the ball to naturally?
But you don't.
I throw it to who?
Naturally.
That's what I'm saying.
That way.
I throw the ball to who?
Naturally.
You ask me.
You throw the ball to who?
Naturally.
Well, say it.
Same as you. I throw the ball to who?
Naturally.
Naturally. Now, whoever it is drops the ball, so the guy runs a second.
Yes.
Who picks up the ball and throws it to what? What throws it to, I don't know. I don't know, throws it back to tomorrow. Triple play.
Yes.
Another guy gets up and it's a long fly ball to be caught. Why? I don't know. He's on third and I don't give a darn.
What'd you say?
I said, I don't give a darn.
Oh, that's our shortstop.
Well, there's one comedy routine that's still hilarious even after you've memorized every line. Abbott and Costello with Who's On First, and the late Steve Goodman, a loyal Chicagoan who actually did spend his last years in Southern California, close to where the Angels play, with a dying Cub fan's last request. We move from the sports page to another juicy part of your morning paper, next on the Dr. Demento Show.
I feel like I have a mask on and I want to rip it off.
It's like a fist at the top of my nose.
My sinus pain lasts all day long.
I want to take the top of my head off and get it all out.
Try Drixoral Sinus, the only sinus medicine that takes sinus pain away right away and keeps it away for up to 12 full hours. And for 12 hours, Drixoral Sinus relieves the pressure and congestion that causes the pain.
The people who make Drixoral Sinus really understand sinus pain.
Drick's Oral Sinus. Use only as directed.
What do you think of new Cineburst gum?
I intend to bring those flavor crystals up at the next PTA meeting.
The taste is bigger than big, dude.
My parents can't handle the speckles.
When I heard the Cineburst crunches, I started a petition stating our deep concern. Care to sign it?
It's intense. That's all I can say.
No, 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 no.
Yes!
New Cineburst with flavor crystals. May not be suitable for adults.
Dr. Demento.
I once knew a gal whose name was Daisy. She was lovely as a summer breeze. Parts of her were big as watermelons. So I asked if I could give them parts a squeeze. Well, Daisy said no. She told me where to go. But I guess rejection ain't my cup of tea. So I climbed into my truck and I put that hammer down and I sent old Daisy to eternity. 18 wheels later, she was history. 18 wheels later, she was gone. 18 wheels later, she was flat as the highway I was rolling on. I once knew a gal whose name was Irma. She was the epitome of grace. And parts of her were big as blown-up beach balls. So I asked if she would stick them in my face. Irma said, no way, and suggested I turn gay. But I don't like no, as I've said once before. So I climbed into my truck, and I put that hammer down. And now Irma don't reject me anymore. 18 wheels later, she was history. 18 wheels later, she was gone. 18 wheels later, she was flat as the highway I was rolling on. I once knew a gal whose name was Mabel. She was very delicate and fair. Parts of her were big as, well, you get the idea. So I asked if she would sandwich me in there. Well, she kicked me in my jewels with the force of 20 mules. And it hurt so bad I thought I'd probably die. But I didn't, so I climbed into my truck and I put that hammer down and I sent her to that hole down in the sky. 18 wheels later, she was history. 18 wheels later, she was gone. Oh, 18 wheels later, she was flat as the highway I was rolling on. Roll on. You know what? It's getting real hard to find a good woman anymore.
Press it to my lips. I take a healthy bite from your dainty fingertips. My joy would be complete, dear, if you were only here. But still I keep your hand as a precious souvenir. Died, I cut it off. I really don't know why. For now, each time I kiss it, I get blood stains on my tie. I'm sorry now I killed you, for our love was something fine. Until they come to get me, I shall hold your hand in mine.
I hold your hand in mine. Tom Lehrer on the Dr. Demento Show from the Tom Lehrer Revisited CD. Barry and the Bookbinders with 18 Wheels Later. That's an unreleased tape. Barry, by the way, is an attorney in Los Angeles. And John Prine, great singer-songwriter who recently won a long-deserved Grammy. We heard one of John's earlier classics, Dear Abby. Coming up, we take a demented look at the rise and fall of communism and some of the weird and wonderful songs it has inspired over here in America. The outrage continues on the Westwood One Radio Network.
What do you think of new Cineburst gum?
I've never seen nothing that color before.
Words can't describe it, my man.
Those flavor crystals frighten me.
Whoosh! But wait, did I say outstanding?
Cineburst crunches. That could be a violation in this state. I'll get back to you.
Yes! New Cineburst with flavor crystals. May not be suitable for adults.
Pressure's like an inflated balloon.
It's like something's filling my face up.
My sinus pain goes from my eye sockets to my jaw.
What makes my pain so bad is that it lasts so long.
Try Drick's Oral Sinus, the only sinus medicine that takes sinus pain away right away and keeps it away for up to 12 full hours. And for 12 hours, Drick's Oral Sinus relieves the pressure and congestion that causes the pain.
Whoever developed Drick's Oral Sinus really knows what sinus pain is.
Drick's Oral Sinus. Use only as directed.
Wants Trident?
I do.
Love the taste?
I do.
Cinnamon, fresh mint, four more flavors.
I do.
Sugar-free Trident, the one gum more dentists recommend, actually tastes great too. So who wants Trident?
I do.
Who does?
I do.
We do.
Who?
I do.
I do.
Good for your teeth, great taste too. Who wants Trident?
I do.
Dr. Demento!
Welcome to Russian Bandstand. This is your host, Nikita Clarkchev. In Russia, almost everybody watches Russian Bandstand. Now everybody watches Russian Bandstand. Next is number one song in Russia.
Like that song.
You got to like that song. It's number one song.
But we don't like...
Who else doesn't like that song?
I don't like...
any other song.
Too late, comrade. Now, anybody else don't like...
We like that song.
All right, now a word from our sponsor. You better listen. Light up Stroganoff. New short-length cigarette. Each cigarette, two puffs. That's all you got time for. Work 22 hours a day, salt mine. Is only cigarette with microphone filter. So be careful, comrade. Secret police are listening. Is only cigarette I smoke. Right, comrade Mamarella Chef?
Right. Is only cigarette you can buy.
Next on the Russian Bandstand is country's number one singing star, Nikita Preslichev. What are you going to sing, Nikita?
Moscow, Dracula, comrade, come on in and have a toke.
No, that's the wrong song. Tomorrow we have new number one singing star. Tomorrow we have new number one song.
Hey, comrade, we are secret police. Tomorrow we have new host on the Russian Bandstand.
Spencer and Spencer. Actually, Dickie Goodman and Mickey Shore, that novelty 45 called Russian Bandstand, pretty well typifies what Americans used to think life in the Soviet Union was like. We're commemorating the rise and fall of Soviet communism on the Dr. Demento Show this week. To judge by recorded songs and comedy, Americans did not pay a whole lot of attention to the Bolshevik Revolution before the 1940s, though there was one moderately popular song in 1926 that deals with the revolution mainly in terms of the vodka consumed by the revolutionaries. Remember, alcohol was illegal in America at the time.
I come from across the sea.
A wild Bolshevik.
A landscape of vodka and tea. And stuff that has a kick.
His girl of itch is waiting there, and she misses he. He will give this place the air for he longs to be.
Bark, 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 bark away. In that Bolsheviki land, oh, itch. Away up there they never shave, so they never get the barber's itch. When they do their dance,
hop,
they wear bloomer pants.
Hop,
when they take a drink, they don't stop to think. Far, 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 far away,
far away.
In that Bolsheviki land, oh, itch. Oy, 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 oy.
Hey, I ski, me ski the whiskey.
Your ski matka from ski to matka.
I must have ski some ski shabatka.
When ski your ski drink ski a matka. Alia. One more cup.
Oh, boy.
Bolsheviki, hey, hey.
Fred Waring's Pennsylvanians on the Dr. Demento Show. Here's just a little bit of more authentic communist music from the 1930s. This one actually a souvenir of the early days of the American Communist Party. Advance, proletariat, to conquer the world! SSR, communist leaders proclaimed that the only legitimate purpose of music and art was to help the government achieve its goals. To help promote Soviet industrialization, a composer named Alexander Vasilievich Musilov made a symphony orchestra sound like a steel foundry. While most Americans watched and listened to things like that with mild amusement, during World War II, when Americans and Soviets were both trying to stop Hitler, our government even told us that the Russian communists were heroes. But anybody who believed that too strongly often paid very dearly for it in later years. I guess we needed somebody else to fight after World War II, and the Soviet Union turned out to be the ones. We fought a very bitter war against Russia and Red China in Korea starting in 1950. During that period, many Americans became convinced, rightly or wrongly, that the communist governments had planted a vast network of spies and sympathizers in the United States, ready to bring down everything near and dear to America's heart at a moment's notice and turn us all into Stalin's godless slaves. These next two records were made during that time.
It was during the last days of the prisoner exchange in Korea. I was there as they came through Freedom Gate, shattered, sick, and lame. And there in a Red Cross tent, a weary group rested when a soldier broke out a deck of cards. A look of hate crossed the tired face of one boy as he sprang up, knocking the cards to the ground. As the cards lay around, many face up, he picked up the ace and began. I hate cards, he said. The commies tried to use them to teach us their false doctrine. They told us the ace meant that there is but one God, the state. We knew that to be untrue, for we were religious boys. And the deuce meant that there were two great leaders, Lenin and Stalin. We could not swallow that. And this tray stood for the three religious superstitions that the Reds would soon destroy, the Catholic, the Protestant, and the Jew. This black four, the soldier boy continued, stood for the four corners of the earth where the hammer and sickle would soon reign supreme. There in that prison camp, we hoped it was a lie. And this red five was the 5 points in their red star. Tears were streaming down the boy's face as he picked up the six. And this six, the commies told us, stood for the six and final wars that America had luckily won. The Revolutionary War, the War of 1812, the Civil War, the Spanish-American War, World War No. 1, and World War No. 2. Now in this war, America would be destroyed. And the seven stood for our seventh foolish day, Sunday, which we wasted on our Lord. The eight stood for the 8 hours every day we would have to spend learning to be progressives. The nine for the cat of nine tails lashed across our back if we ever knelt to pray. The 10 was to remind us that our 10 commandments were 10 stupid rules that capitalistic fools believed in. The jack meant that Christ was a knave of uncertain birth. The queen, that Mary his mother, was a non-virtuous woman. And the king stood for our Lord God, who the commies told us did not exist, a dream, a fake, a joke. The heart stood for Christ's blood, all shed in vain. The diamond signified the real precious jewel, the Communist Party. The club, the weapon of oppression with which they beat us, and the spade, a tool with which we would dig our own graves. This was the red deck of cards. Fellas, that's why I hate cards, the soldier boy said, as his buddies picked up the cards, tore them into pieces, and with shining faces, walked toward a simple chapel in Korea.
Country, that's the finest place on earth, but some folks don't appreciate this land that gave them birth. I hear that up in Washington they're having an awful fuss, 'cause communists and spies are making monkeys out of us. The bureaus and departments have been busy night and day. They're figuring out just how we gave our secrets all away. And Congress has appointed a committee, so they said, to find out who's American and who's a low-down red. They call him up to Washington to speak for Uncle Sam, but when they ask them what they are, they shut up like a clam. I wish they'd take and put me on the witness stand today. I'd shout so loud old Stalin could hear me all the way. I'm no communist, I'll tell you that right now. I believe a man should own his own house and car and cow. I like this private ownership, I want to be left alone. Let the government run its business and let me run my own. Our government is bigger than it ever was today. The more they hire to work for it, the more they have to pay. Our public servants should be proud and honest, you would think, instead of taking bribes and dressing up their wives and mean. The taxes keep on going up, of that there is no doubt, but still they just can't take it in as fast as they dish it out. Our national debt is monster-sizing, growing every day. Our children's children still unborn are gonna have to pay. Our dollar used to be the soundest money on this earth, but now $2 won't even buy one good dollar's worth. Unless we stop inflation and take care of what we've got, the communists may win the fight and never fire a shot. Oh, I'm no communist, I'll tell you that right now. I believe a man should own his own house and car and cow. I like this private ownership, I want to be left alone. Let the government run its business and let me run my own.
Well, I'd have to confess, at least the second half of that song still makes a fair amount of sense today. I'm No Communist, written by Scotty Wiseman, sung by Grandpa Jones in 1952. The Red Deck of Cards, written and sung by Red River Dave McEnery. We'll take our demented history of communism into the 1960s and beyond with Bob Dylan, Procter and Bergman, and more right after this.
It's like being hit right below your eyes.
If someone put a needle in your head, it would explode.
My sinus pain just lasts so long.
I can't even wear my glasses because of the sensitivity.
Try Drix Oral Sinus, the only sinus medicine that takes sinus pain away right away and keeps it away for up to 12 full hours. And for 12 hours, Drix Oral Sinus relieves the pressure and congestion that causes the pain.
The people who make Drix Oral Sinus really understand sinus pain.
Drix Oral Sinus. Use only as directed.
Who wants Trident?
I do!
Love the taste?
I do!
Cinnamon, fresh mint, and four more flavors.
I do!
Sugar-free Trident, the one gum more dentists recommend, actually tastes great, too. So who wants Trident?
I do!
Who does?
I do!
We do!
Who?
I do!
I do!
Good for your teeth, great taste, too. Who wants Trident?
I do!
In the early 1950s, America was all but torn apart by the witch hunts of Senator Joseph McCarthy, who thought he saw a communist under every bed. His spiritual successor, starting in the early 1960s, was the John Birch Society.
You can't mess around with marijuana. If you do in Russia, you're a goner. 'Cause that firing squad is always ready. And the guys on it are working steady. So why don't they go and live in Russia? Those yippies that get all their kicks from smoking pot and throwing bricks should try a couple of those tricks in Russia. They don't let you demonstrate or riot. And in Russia, no one ever tries it. If you do, they send you to Siberia. After that, no one'll see or hear you. So why don't they go and live in Russia? Those hippies that just rant and rave, that never comb their hair or shave, would have to go to work and slave in Russia. When I wake up tired and disgusted, 'cause the bills and groceries keep me busted, and all I get free is indigestion, then I ask myself one simple question. Now how would I like to live in Russia? The taxes here keep getting worse, and that pollution is a curse. To keep a roof above my head, there's no bologna on my bread. And yet despite the woes I've got, and though there's nothing left to hawk, I'm mighty lucky that I'm not in Russia. I'm mighty lucky that I'm not in Russia.
A pair from the 60s there. Bob Dylan with the talking John Birch Paranoid Blues, and from somewhere way out on the outer fringes of the music business came Lada Howard singing In Russia. I'm Dr. Demento, saying goodbye to Soviet communism, and the most requested song I've ever played having anything at all to do with communism was this song, recorded by Chicago's Tim Kavanaugh not long after Premier Gorbachev came to power in 1985.
With all the news that there is today, it's hard to keep it all inside my brain. Big Russian guys are dropping like flies. How can I remember all of their names? Now there's help, it's a brand new game. It's the ABCs of dead Russian leaders. The ABCs of dead Russian leaders. When you hear the letter A and drop off is the name to say. The letter B is next in line. Russian in life, Russian toward death. They read Russian books, they wore Russian dressing. cause he's dead too. Ooh, Constantine and Yuri, just like that, they were gone in a hurry. Before them, there was Leon, and his name was hard to rhyme until he started being dead. Gorbachev thinks he's home free because his name doesn't start with B. But it's my game, I can change it if I want to. I can make it the A, B, C, G. When you hear the letter A and drop off is the name to say. The letter B is next in line, fresh, next dead, so we'll do just fine. C is for turn and go, it's the ABCs of dead Russian leaders. The ABCs of dead Russian leaders. The ABCs of dead Russian leaders. The ABCs of dead, 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 dead Russian leaders.
The bell was ringing, it was dark, the park was closing, still she held onto my arm. She was a peasant girl, a pleasant girl, and yes, she drove a tractor on a farm. And as the summer night began, and as the trolley sparked that ran on silver tracks in circles round and round the park, she held my hand, Manhattan hand, and whispered low her five-year plan. Then we depart. Oh, Moscow memories, you haunt me still. Communist memories erode my will. The park was closed, the gate locked shut. We walked the streets, the massive empty streets, alone. And after walking all the night, I took her home, I kissed her once. We said goodbye. She had no food. And now so many years have passed, and here I sit on Wall Street and recall that in my younger days I kissed a communist, a red-haired Russian lass. Oh, Moscow melodies, you haunt me still. Marxist memories destroy my will. Now the government has asked me please to sign my name to papers just to siphon off a little of my cash. To fight a war, support a horror, close a park, or build an ark in space, or buy the president some hash. And I can't do it, I just can't do it. For I remember still those Moscow memories, sweet Soviet melodies. Those commie kisses destroyed my will, sweet whispered wishes. Those Russian witches, those red hot kisses, destroyed my will.
Phil Proctor and Peter Bergman of Firesign Theater fame winding up our personal demented memorial service for Russian communism with a communist love song that they recorded in 1973. Tim Cavanaugh with the ABCs of dead Russian leaders. I'm Dr. Demento. So much for the Soviet Union, but now that Russian communism is gone, America has gotten involved in a different kind of rivalry, a strictly capitalistic rivalry. Song about that next on the Westwood One Radio Network.
What do you think of new Cineburst gum?
I don't like anything new. Get that microphone out of my face.
Cineburst? Oh, absolutely. It's the best.
It crunches. Those kids deny it, but I know the gum crunches.
It's too much for my dad. Sometimes it's almost too much for me.
All I can tell you at this time is that we're keeping a very close eye on it.
Yes!
New Cineburst with flavor crystals. May not be suitable for adults.
Who wants Trident?
I do, I do!
Love the taste?
I do, I do!
Cinnamon, fresh mint, four more flavors.
I do, I do!
I do, I do!
Sugar-free Trident, the one gum more dentists recommend, actually tastes great too. So who wants Trident?
I do, I do!
Who does?
I do, I do!
We do, we do!
Who?
I do,
I do!
I do,
I do!
Good for your teeth, great taste too. Who wants Trident?
I do!
What do you think of new Cineburst gum?
I intend to bring those flavor crystals up at the next PTA meeting.
The taste is bigger than big, dude.
My parents can't handle the speckles.
When I heard the Cineburst crunches, I started a petition stating our deep concern. Care to sign it?
It's intense. That's all I can say.
No.
Yes!
New Cineburst with flavor crystals. May not be suitable for adults.
This is new from the man who sang Kick-Ass USA. It's Milo Tremley.
I got a 4x4, a Nissan, and a 4-door Toyota. Going out to buy some Fujifilm to put in my Minota. A Sony telephone, you can leave a message on it. You can beat me anywhere because I pack a Panasonic. I keep my Kirin beer inside my sand refrigerator. Got a Toshiba microwave, that's how I'll bake my taters. From Honda to Hitachi, I got a Casio. They're laughing all the way to the Bank of Tokyo. Singing.
Miss American Pie, Harold Sushi, Mitsubishi, kiss your Chevy, bye-bye. Good old boys drinking sake and lye, singing, Bonsai, Bonsai, ha ha ha.
Are you tired of politicians?
Yeah.
Are you tired of Republicans and Democrats?
Yeah.
Are you tired of the liberals?
Yeah.
Are you tired of the reactionary right-wingers?
Yeah.
Are you tired of answering these questions?
Yeah.
I live in California, the land of Mercedes. I drive a BMW bus. Everybody's speaking politically correct. Well, I go down the street and just cuss. They say don't eat meat, but I say read me. Throw another slab of bacon on my steak. Banana, patter, butter, but don't put on another, cause I've had about as much as I can take. And I say blab, 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 blab. Well, the Republicans blame the Democrats for spending, but Reagan drove the country into debt. The Democrats blame the Republicans for cheating, meanwhile they're off in someone else's bed. And I gotta work two jobs, form a family, can't buy a house like my mom and dad. The car is German, my TV Japanese, and I'm all American mad, so I say blah 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 blah. Everybody! Health insurance is too high, my paycheck is too low, and everybody down at the DMV is just too slow. My Visa and MasterCard are at their limit, my taxes are overdue. And if you ask me about the 92 election, this is what I'll say to you. I go blah 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 blah. Come on, you know the words. Blah 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 blah.
Loose Bruce Kerr with some choice commentary on the current campaign, All American Mad, the blah blah song, and a couple for our friends in Japan. Turning Japanese by the Vapors. I have a copy of that was pressed in Japan, and I wonder how they translated the lyrics of that one for the locals. And Bonsai Bonsai, a new and unreleased tape from Milo Tremley on the Dr. Demento Show. And now, Dimensions and Dementites, what time is it? And here they are, the hottest and the coolest demented discs and tapes of the week. The Dr. Demento Funny Five. Number five, an all-time demented favorite with Mr. Brian Bowers.
Well, a Scotsman clad in kilt left a bar one evening fair. And one could tell by how he walked that he'd drunk more than his share. He fumbled round until he could no longer keep his feet. And he stumbled off into the grass to sleep beside the street. Ring ding diddle diddle idio, ring da diddly io. He stumbled off into the grass to sleep beside the street. About that time, two young and lovely girls just happened by. One says to the other with a twinkle in her eye, "See yon sleeping Scotsman, so strong and handsome built. I wonder if it's true what they don't wear beneath the kilt." Ring ding diddle little idio, ring da diddly io. I wonder if it's true what they don't wear beneath the kilt. They crept up on that sleeping Scotsman quiet as could be, lifted up his kilt about an inch so they could see, and there, behold, for them to view beneath his Scottish skirt was nothing more than God had graced him with upon his birth. Ring ding diddle little idio, ring da diddly io, was nothing more than God had graced him with upon his birth. They marveled for a moment, then one said, "We must be gone. Let's leave a present for our friend before we move along." As a gift they left a blue silk ribbon tied into a bow. Around the bonny star the Scots kilt did lift and show. Ring ding diddle little idio, ring da diddly io. Around the bonny star the Scots kilt did lift and show. Now the Scotsman woke to nature's call and stumbled towards the trees. Behind the bush he lifts his kilt and gawks at what he sees. And in a startled voice he says to what's before his eyes, "Oh, lad, I don't know where you've been, but I see you won first prize." Ring ding diddle little laddie-o, ring da diddly io. Oh, lad, I don't know where you've been, but I see you won first prize.
The Scotsman, written by Mike Cross in the style of olden ribaldry and sung with gusto by Brian Bowers. Number 5 on the Funny 5. Sounds like a call on the hotline for number 4. Hello.
Hello, Doctor. If this is Raffy Wolf, press 1. If I get demented on WZLX, press 2. If you can play that piece about the guy who gets robbed and can't get a policeman, press 3.
We're sorry. Your call cannot be completed as dialed.
Well, excuse me, sir, but could you see your way clear to helping out a poor soul who's down on his luck?
Why, you ignorant, filthy little pile of pigeon excrement. You putrid dung heap of humanity. You unworthy, low-life, slime-sucking, vomit-licking scum lover. Why on earth would I want to help you?
I have a gun.
Prefer cash or check?
Hand over your wallet, your watch, your jewelry. Come on. I'm double parked. I don't want to get ticket.
Well, at least let me keep my Rolex. I paid $40 for it, eh?
Too bad. Tell it to your insurance company. Look, I gotta run. Have a nice day.
Wait, stop! Help! I've been robbed! Excuse me. You've gotta help me.
Why, you ignorant, filthy little pile of pigeon excrement.
No. No, you don't understand. I've just been robbed.
Too bad. Call a cop.
Yeah, a cop, right. Okay, yeah, cop. There's a payphone on the corner. Yeah, please, will help me.
Operator,
can you get me the police? Quick, this is an emergency. Come on.
Police department.
Hello, officer. You've got to help me. I've just been robbed. He took everything. My new wallet, my money, my Beaver Lumber credit card. Look, you've got to send someone. A squad car, the emergency task force. Hello? Is anyone there?
There's no one in the station right now. At the sound of the tone, you may leave a message. If you want to talk to a real person, push the number 1 on your touch-tone phone.
Okay, number 1. Come on, hurry up.
Okay, 2 maple and a double chocolate. Hello, police department.
Hello, listen, I've just been robbed, and...
If you wish to report a crime, push 1 on your touch-tone telephone. If you are looking for a job, push 2 on your telephone. If you are turning yourself in, push 3. And if you have any information regarding important donut sales, push 4.
What was the crime number?
That would be 1.
Oh, thanks.
Okay.
Come on, let's get going.
Hello, criminal investigation.
Oh, finally.
If you're reporting a domestic crime, press 1. If you're reporting a parking violation, littering offense, or murder, press 2. If you're reporting a robbery, press 3.
Okay, 3, right.
Yeah, robbery division.
Are you a real person?
Of course I'm a real person.
Oh, at last. Listen, I want to report a robbery.
But I'm not in at the moment. If you need immediate assistance, press the following number on your phone. If you witnessed a robbery, 1. If you're the victim of a robbery, 2. If you are a robber, 3.
Okay, Okay, two, right. Come on.
Hello, robbery victims. May I help you?
Listen, I was just robbed.
If you were robbed by a man over 6 feet, press one. If you were robbed by a man under 5 feet, press two. If you were robbed by an Albanian dwarf named Cyrano, press three. If you were robbed by the Dutch national basketball team, press four. If it was a woman's team, press five. If somebody's...
The Royal Canadian Air Farce with Dial 1 for Help, number 4 in this week's Funny 5. A comedian who first became well-known in comedy circles as Mr. Bullhorn has lately written a bunch of funny songs. One of them's number 3, and it's next.
Who wants Trident?
I do!
Love the taste?
I do!
Cinnamon, fresh mint, 4 more flavors.
I do!
Sugar-free Trident, the one gum more dentists recommend, actually tastes great too. So who wants Trident?
I do!
Who does?
I do!
We do!
Who?
I do!
I do!
Good for your teeth, great taste too. Who wants Trident?
I do!
What do you think of new Cineburst gum?
I've never seen nothing that color before.
Words can't describe it, my man.
Those flavor crystals frighten me.
Wow! Whoosh! But wait, did I say outstanding?
Cineburst crunches. That could be a violation in this state. I'll get back to you.
Yes! New Cineburst with flavor crystals. May not be suitable for adults.
From the human to the panda to the bee, love the whale, the amoeba, and the bat. I love every breathing thing except the cat. Kill a cat, kill a cat, bash his brains in with a bat. They're not so brave in your microwave, so kill a cat today. They won't come when you call, shred the drapes in the hall. They just lie around and look cute. You can't teach them tricks like retrieving sticks, so I teach cats skydiving with no parachute. Here, kitty, 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 kitty. Kill a cat, use your car and they go splat. Their 9 lives expire when tossed in a fire. So make a cat a road pizza today.
Glenn's super not encouraging catricide with that number, mind you, just maybe contemplating it. Don't try it at home. Kill a cat. Number 3 on the Funny 5. Here's number 2.
Every year I drive out to Cape Cod for the last part of June. Leave the city by 10 and you're there in the late afternoon. On the way there's a village called Marion that you pass through. The first time I approached it, I'll always remember the sign that came into view. It said, entering Marion, and I thought, what a fun little sign. But the feeling of entering Marion had a kick that was hard to define. A rapturous rush, a physical flush, chills up and down the spine. For the few minutes I was in Marion, all Massachusetts was mine. Well, it got to be kind of an annual thing, the event that would start each vacation off with a bang. Then one year, who knows why, I decided to try a new route. So I got out my map and I traced one I thought was a butte. After driving all morning, I came to the top of a hill, where a sign stood before me that promised a new kind of thrill. It said, entering Beverly, which was lovely and not overbuilt. And the pleasure of entering Beverly far outweighed any feelings of guilt. I could say I'm contrite, but it wouldn't be right, for the truth is that later that day, I found myself entering Sharon. It was there, so was I. We enjoyed it, hey, what can I say? By the next year, I'd try any route just for novelty's sake. I was cursed with a thirst that no single township could slake. Oh, at the wheel I looked calm, but inside I was running amok. When a sign in the road dead ahead sent me straight into shock. Entering Lawrence, my God, I was out of control. And I'd no sooner finished with Lawrence than boom, I was entering Lowell. Then I backtracked and re-entered Lawrence, then Quincy and Norton as well. Around midnight I pulled into Athol and flopped in a Fleabag motel. I slept fitfully in my clothing and awoke in a pool of sweat and self-loathing, lying there feeling lower than carrion. A name came clear as a clarion. I jumped in my car, and before very far I was entering Marion. How totally wonderfully great, how grand to be entering Marion after tramping all over the state. Every sleaze bucket verb, every tryst by the curb had really just helped me to find. I'm happiest entering Marion, I guess I'm the Marion kind. Marion kind.
John Forster and Entering Marion from his as yet unfinished and unreleased album. If you're in Manhattan sometime soon, by the way, look in the Village Voice or one of the other local papers and you might find a notice about one of John's live shows. He does quite a few in New York. Entering Marion is number two this week, which means we've got a new number one.
It's time. This is it. Here it comes. Number one.
Good afternoon, passengers, and welcome aboard today's flight. We hope you're enjoying your trip. And if you're not, it's your own darn fault. If we can assist you in any way, please let us know and we'll help you if we feel up to it, okay? Thank you for flying PMS Airlines.
Magazine, sir?
What do you have?
Cosmopolitan, Mademoiselle, Flair, Chatelaine.
Do you have Sports Illustrated?
No, you got a problem with that?
No. I just couldn't help noticing all the magazines are sort of woman-oriented.
Yeah, so? That's just the way it is, okay?
Oh, yeah, okay, fine, yeah. I'll just take a pillow.
Pillow? Oh. Pillow? He wants a pillow.
Tracy, come on, get a hold of yourself. Now listen, go back to the galley, okay? It's time for the meals anyway.
Yes, all right, whatever you say. Bitch.
Sir, on behalf of PMS Airlines, please let me offer my sincerest apology. I'm awfully sorry about Tracy.
It's quite all right. I understand.
Thank you, sir. Now, please, allow me to offer you a bottle of our special French wine with our compliments, of course.
Oh, it isn't necessary, but yeah, thank you very much.
Do you prefer red or white?
Red.
So what's wrong with the white?
I'll have
the white.
Oh, okay. Very good, sir. White it is.
Great.
And as long as I'm here, I'll just take your dinner order. Now, you have a choice of fish or chicken.
Which would you recommend?
Well, they're both very good.
So it doesn't matter to you which I have?
No. It's your choice, sir. You are, after all, the passenger.
Okay, I'll have the fish.
You bastard.
I mean the chicken.
No, look, it is too late, you ungrateful potato head. Look, after all the trouble I went to making you a delicious chicken dinner, and then you just go and you just throw it in my face.
Chicken is fine, really. I love chicken. Chicken is fine.
Hey, Tracy, one fish dinner for Mr. Hotshot.
Coming up.
Look, chicken would be okay.
Here's your fish dinner, you scum-sucking maggot. I choke on a bone and die.
It spilled the food all over me.
It looks good on you.
I'll be around with tea and coffee later.
Hey, keep it down out here. What's all this commotion? What's
you
wrong?
You wouldn't believe this.
Captain, this troublemaker, he doesn't want the chicken dinner.
Is that what all this commotion is about? A simple dinner order? Francine, for goodness sake, get a grip on yourself. You go and help Tracy fly the airplane. I'll look after this mess. Sir, I deeply apologize for my crew.
It's all right, really.
You sure?
Yeah, listen, I just want to get off this plane and forget the whole incident.
What's that supposed to mean? You knocking the way I'm running this flight? I'll have you know I never wanted this pilot's job in the first place. I wanted to be at home raising the kids, but no, I've got to be stuck in a career of my own. You got one hell of a nerve, buddy. I ought to pop you one right in the kisser. Oh, no, now he's locked himself in the bathroom. I'll rip your lips off if you don't come out, buddy. Don't set off the fire detector either.
PMS Airlines. It's not just a trip. It's a flight to hell once a month.
And that's the Royal Canadian Air Force, which has flown right to the top of the Funny Five with PMS Airlines number one on the Funny Five. Our thanks once again to Bruce Taves of Winnipeg for smuggling that great Canadian dementia south of the border for us. I'll be right back with a Weird About Next Week show.
What do you think of new Cineburst gum?
I don't like anything new. Get that microphone out of my face.
Cineburst? Oh, absolutely. It's the best.
It crunches. Those kids deny it, but I know the gum crunches.
It's too much for my dad. Sometimes it's almost too much for me.
All I can tell you at this time is that we're keeping a very close eye on it.
Yes!
New Cineburst with flavor crystals. May not be suitable for adults.
Who wants Trident?
I do!
Love the taste?
I do!
Cinnamon, fresh mint, four more flavors.
I do!
Sugar-free Trident, the one gum more dentists recommend, actually tastes great too. So who wants Trident?
I do!
Who does?
I do! We do!
Who?
I do!
I do!
Good for your teeth, great taste too. Who wants Trident?
I do!
What do you think of new Cineburst gum?
I intend to bring those flavor crystals up at the next PTA meeting.
The taste is bigger than big, dude.
My parents can't handle the speckles.
When I heard the Cineburst crunches, I started a petition stating our deep concern. Care to sign it?
It's intense. That's all I can say.
No.
Yes!
New Cineburst with flavor crystals. May not be suitable for adults.
Ah, here I am again, comrades, thanking you for joining me for our demented history of Russian communism and other delights from the stacks and stacks of laughing wax. I haven't picked a special topic for next week, so unless I get a sudden inspiration, it'll be another freeform show with lots of your requests, the funniest records ever made, and one or two of the worst. Just don't know what might happen, neither do I, which makes it more fun. Remember, you can write to me anytime, P.O. Box 884, Culver City, California 90232, P.O. Box 884, Culver City, California 90232. 7232. Don't forget the hotline, 1-900-773-7333. If you're under 18, ask your folks. It's just 75 cents a minute, 125 first minute. Doug Corbin is the associate producer of the Dr. Demento Show. Steve Thrapp is our engineer. Bob Ebersole, production assistant, with research by Warren Debenham. The Dr. Demento Show is a weekly presentation of the Westwood One Radio Network. Executive producer, Norm Pattiz. Don't forget to stay demented!